right. So the next topic which is coming up over here is joint. Very important topic. It is very important topic from the interview point of view as well as from the real time point of view. Okay, so joints. So if you are taking notes, I will insist you to write down one line that joints are required when we need to retrieve the data from more than one table. And if you remember this line, I can guarantee you that you can never get confused in joints. So I repeat, joints are required when we need to retrieve the data from more than one table. Joins are required when you need to retrieve the data from more than one table. Okay. Sorry. So there are different type of join, which are inner join, left join, right join, full join, Cartesian join, and self join. So let's talk about these joins one by one. And here it goes. So let me give you an example. And I have a table you have already seen, select. EFP. So here I have 111 records and I have the personal details like employee ID, name, address, city, phone number, email, date of birth, and date of joining. Then let us try another from EMP underscore cell. So the employee salary table, I have 69 records in which I have employee ID, department designation, and salary. Let me execute both the queries and I'm getting the output of the two. Now, what I want to get the employee ID, name, city, date of joining, department designation, and salary. So what is the challenge in this requirement? The challenge is that I have a requirement to get the data from more than one table. Sorry, I have a requirement to get the data from more than one table. So how can we get this? So let's create, here we need them. So as you have seen, a requirement to get the data from more than one table and for which we need a join. So let's create a join. I will say select. From the employee table, take employee ID. From the employee table, take name. From the employee table, take city. From the employee table, take date of joining. From the employee salary table, take department. Oops, my bad. From the employee salary table, take department. From the employee salary table, take designation. From the employee salary table, take salary. From EMP. Inner join EMP underscore cell on EMP.EID equals EMP underscore cell. EID. Let me execute this and see what are we getting over here. What is employee ID, name, city, department, oh, from here I have given a comma, typo error. I am getting 69 records over here. And I'm getting details, employee ID, name, city, date of joining, department designation, and salary. So employee ID, name, city, date of joining has been taken from the employee table, and department designation salary has been taken from the employee salary table. Okay, so now let's try to understand this query. What I have written, select the name, the list of the columns which I need to extract. So select from the employee table. So here Till now, I have not given you any example where I have preceded the name of the table along with the name of the field. But here we are specifying the name of the table as emp.eid. So I am saying SQL to get the employee ID from the employee table. emp.name, get the name from the employee table. empsalary.salary, empsalary.designation. So I am telling SQL that this particular information needs to be extracted from which table, because now we have two tables. Initially there was only one table, so it is no need to specify, but as we have two tables, we are clarifying SQL that this particular information needs to be extracted from this particular from emp inner join employee salary, from table 1 join table 2, from in table 1 join table 2, and in join I am using inner join. So inner join means inner join will return the common records from both the table. As you can see in the output, you are getting 69 records. In one table I was having 111 records, and in another table I had 69 records, but in a join I am getting 69 records. So these are the 69 records which are common in both the tables. On now, on emp.eid is equal to employee salary.eid. On emp.eid is equal to employee salary.eid. So whenever we create a join, the only one requirement for the join is the two table must have one common field. There should be one common field between the two table, then only you will be able to create a join. Okay, so we have provided select table list, select column list from table 1 join table 2. On table 1 dot common field is equal to table 2 dot common field. Simple syntax, right? So here we are getting the details of the employee, the details from the two different tables. Now, you might think that, okay, writing the name of the table again and again is quite complicated. And as of now, the table name is small and we are taking the data only for 6-7 columns, so it is fine. But in a real-time scenario, you have a requirement of getting a data for 30-40 columns, and the table name can also be a long. So writing the name of the table again and again will be quite complicated. Writing the name of the column again and again will be quite complicated. So in this case, let's try to make this query more simpler. So I will say select e1.eid, e1.name, e1.city, e1.date of joining, e2.department, e2.designation, e2.salary from emp e1 inner join emp underscore cell e2 on emp.eid equals emp underscore, sorry, on we have given e1.eid is equal to e2.eid. Let me execute this and see what happens. I am getting the same output, same 69 records are being displayed over here as well. So what I have done, what is the change in this query? Instead of writing the name of the table again and again, I have replaced the name of the table with the command e1 and e2 with the, I have given a nickname, and these are technically known as alias. Okay, and very simple way to remember this, alias. Just like all of us have a actual name, right? Like my actual name, Rajiv Garg. So professionally, I have been known as Rajiv Garg, but my family and friends, they may call me Chotu, Raju, whatever. So we always have some nickname which is used by our, within our social circle, family, friends call it by a nickname. Why? Because it is easier to refer, right? So same over here, I don't want to write the name of the table again and again. So I have given a nickname to it technically, which is known as table alias. So e1.eid, e1.name, and where I have defined this alias over here, emp e1, emp cell e2. So this is the place where I'm specifying the alias. Okay, I hope it is clear. All right. Okay, now if you still think the query is quite tough and you want me to make it simpler, so let's try to do so. Let's try to make this query more simpler. So I will say select emp dot eid comma name comma city comma department comma designation comma salary. I missed date of joining. From emp winner join emp underscore cell on emp dot eid is equal to emp underscore cell dot eid. Let me execute this. Same output, same 69 records are being displayed over here. And if you notice, what is the change in the initial query and this query? So in both the initial query, I have specified the SQL to get the data from which particular table. But here I am not specifying. I am not specifying the name of the table from which the respective column needs to be fetched. Okay, I'm not specifying that. And I'm specifying it only in the employee ID. So that is the difference between two. Now, because SQL is smart enough to understand that if the name is there in the employee table, obviously it will be taking from the employee table. If the salary is there in the salary table, obviously it will be taking the details from the salary table. But the challenge lies in case of the employee ID, when the column exists in both the table. In this case, the SQL will get confused. And when we have to specify that this particular data needs to be extracted from which particular table. Right, so I hope it is clear. Right, so this is a join. So we have talked about a inner join over here. Right, so let's take another type of join. So the next join which we have over here is a left join. And to give you an example of the left join, I will copy the same query from above, and I will make only one small change. Instead of the word inner, I will use left, and let's see what happens. And you can see initially we have got 69 records over here. Now, if you will see, I'm getting 111 records over here. And if you will see, let me scroll down, you can see a lot of nulls over here. So this means left join. Left join means all the records from the left table and the matching records from the right table. All the records from the left table and the matching records from the right table. And how you will come to know which is the left and which is the right table? So any table which is coming before the keyword join is left, and after the keyword join is right. So from the employee table, we are taking employee ID, name, city, date of joining. All these details are coming. And from the second table, only the matching records are being displayed. Then again, I will take this And instead of left, I will simply write right. Right join. Right join. So what does right, as the name says, all the records from right table matching records from this left table. Here it is. And you will see I'm getting 69 records over here because I do not have any such record which exists in the salary table but does not exist in the employee table. And to give you a more better example, I have another two tables. So I have a select star from EMP underscore cell. Let's take EMP and select star from and I have another table called CJ2. So I have two tables over here, CJ1 and CJ2. And if you will look at these tables, in the table CJ1, I have the roll number and name, and in the CJ table CJ2, I have the roll number and mark. So in the CJ1, we have the roll number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And in the table CJ2, we have the roll number 1, 2, 3, 10, 11. So 4, 5 are the roll number which are available in CJ1, but not in CJ2. And 10, 11 are the roll number which are available in CJ2, but not in CJ1. Now let's try to create a join over here. So I will say, select CJ1.rollNumber from CJ1.name, comma, CJ2.marks from CJ1 inner join CJ2 on CJ1.rollNumber is equal to CJ2.rollNumber. Okay, so you can see I am getting the common records between the two. Let's try to input a left join over here. And let us see first both the tables over here. Left join, all the records from left matching from right. So instead of inner, I will make it as left. So what should I get? I will get all the roll number and name and the marks for the matching one. Here it goes. Let me take a right join. Oh, sorry. Let me show these tables. Now I have used a right join. That means all the records from right, and right is CJ2 and matching from left. So I will be getting all the marks, but matching roll number and name. So let us see. Here it is. So all the marks, but matching roll number and name. Then another join we have is a full join. As the name says, all the records from both the tables. You are getting all the records from both the tables. Okay. So, this is a full join. And to remember the join, inner join, left join, right join, full join, the best way to remember is just a small figure. If you remember this figure, you will never be confused in the joins. Inner join, common between the two tables. Right join, all from right, matching from left. Left join, all from left, matching from right. Full join, all the records from both the tables. All the records from both the tables. Okay, I hope it is clear. Let's proceed further and let's see the next type of join which is coming up over here is Cartesian join, which is also referred to as a cross join. It is also very important, specifically from the interview point of view. So cross join means a cross product. So for an example, if I have in one table, I have 1, 2, 3, and in another table, I have A, B, C, D. Now, how it will work, a cross join or a Cartesian join, it will take all the records of one table and match with the first record of second table. Again, all records of first table with second record of second table and so on. So it will be something like 1A, 2A, 3A, 1B, 2B, 3B, 1C, 2C, 3C, 1D, 2D, 3D. Right? So if one table has 3 records and another table has 4 records, so the total number of records in the output is 4 into 3, that is equal to 12. So that is what we are getting over here in the cross join. So let's try to create a cross join. So I will say select CJ1 dot roll number comma CJ1 dot name marks. From CJ1 cross join CJ2. Here it is. So you can see in the output you are getting 25 records because both the table has 5 records each. So you can see all the roll number in an age, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, with the first marks, that is 90. Then again 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 with the second marks, that is 95. With then again 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 with the third marks, that is 80, and so on. So this is a cross join. Now, if you notice the join over here, if you notice the join, there is some syntactical difference. There is some syntactical difference in this join with comparison to the other joins. And what is this difference? In all the other joins, we have used the on keyword. But here we have not used the on keyword. So let's see what happens if we specify the on keyword over here. And let's try to execute. I am getting an error. Why? Because cross join does not accept on keyword. However, if you want, you can use where. And if you utilize where and see the output which you are getting, and which is this output? This is the output of inner join. And this is the very important question in the interview, the relationship between a cross and an inner join. So we say cross join plus pair is equal to inner join. Cross join plus pair cross is equal to inner join. Okay, there it is. Right. So this was the cross join. Remember this relationship, cross plus where is equal to inner. Then another type of join. This is something really interesting, which is known as self join. Now, first of all, there is nothing known as self join, and I will write it for you. And you can also note down for all of those who are taking the notes. You can note down this line. There is nothing known as self join. There is nothing known as self join. And if there is nothing known as self join, why should we read this topic? No need to read this topic. There is nothing known as self join. So I'm skipping this topic. And let me give you one example, right? Let us consider some another example over here. So, and let me create a visual example for you. Here, so I have a table for this in there, and I will make it accordingly. Yep, this looks good. It is now. Just try to see what I have created for you. If you can call it as an organizational structure, where A being the big boss, right? A being the big boss. Under A, we have two employees, that is B and C. Under B, we have one employee, that is D. Under C, we have two employees, that is E and F. And under F, we have one employee, that is G. Okay. And this structure I have also created in SQL. See over here. Right, so you can see A is the big boss. There is no boss of A. B and C, this is the boss ID. So B and C, the boss is A, one, that is A. Then C, the boss is one, that is A. D, the boss is two, that is B. E and F, the boss is three, that is C. And G, the boss is F, that is three. Right. So this is a structure we have over here. Now, I also have one more table. Select star from boss. So I have a boss table also. Now you can see both of these tables. One, I have the employee table, and another, I have a boss table. Now focus on this very carefully. So something interesting coming up over here. Now I have a requirement. I need to get the employee ID, the name, and the boss name. So it's a simple join. So I will say select from SJ. I will take ID from SJ. I will take name from boss. I will take name from first table, that is SJ. Let us take it as left join. SJ. Oh, sorry, not SJ. It is boss from left time. Boss on. Now, which two column we need to compare? We need to compare the boss ID and the BID. So on SJ dot boss ID equals boss dot BID. And let me execute this. So you can see I'm getting the name of the bosses. So you can compare A, the boss is null, A is the super boss. There is no boss of A. Then B and C, the boss is A. D, the boss is B. E and F, the boss is C. And F, the boss is, G, the boss is F. Okay, so the same structure is appearing over here. Once again, we will look at these two tables and tell me one thing. Is boss of an company also an employee of that company? Is boss also an employee? Is boss also an employee? Yes, a boss, although he is a boss, but yes, he is also an employee of the company. Now look at this table, these two tables from a different perspective. In the first table, I am storing the employee ID and name. And in the second table also, I am storing the employee ID and the name. That means I am storing the same information at multiple places. I'm storing the same information at multiple places, and which is against the normalization. Which is against normalization, because normalization says that there shouldn't be any data redundancy, no duplicacy of the data. So that means I should not have a table called boss. Now, let's assume we have only one table and I have a same requirement. I need employee ID, name, and the boss name. So how can I get it? So let us see if I create two copies. Just to show you, I'm creating a two copies of the table. I'm just executing the same command twice. So I'm getting the two copies of the same table. And now you can see that I need to compare this column with this column to get the desired output. The boss ID with the ID needs to be compared. So that I'm just copying pasting the same command so that you can see the where I have made the difference. So select sj.id, sj.name, or in fact, I will call it as from S1. Let me refer to the first one as S1 and the second one as S2. So from select s1.id, S1.name. S2.name from SJ. S1, that is this one, the first one. Left join SJ. S2, that is this one. On S1.bossID is equal to s2.id. Let me execute this. Command completed, and we get the desired output. Same output we are getting over here. Right? So let me execute the three. Oops, Control Z. All the three together so that you can see the output. So from here, it has taken the employee ID and the name, and from here it will take the boss name. It will search for the respective boss name over here, take the name, and will put it over here. So it is comparing the two copies of the same table, or in other words, let me display only one table. I can also say that it is comparing the third column of the table with the first column of the table. The third and the first column of the table are being compared. That means I can also say that a table has been compared to itself. A table has been compared to itself, and that is known as self-join. This is known as self-join, where a table is being compared to itself. Okay, but you might be wondering, few minutes back I told you, in fact I have also written that there is nothing known as self-join. Now I am saying that this is known as a self-join. Then what is correct? Either I was lying initially or I am lying now. So I was not lying initially, not now, because still I do say there is nothing known as self-join. Because if you will look at this query, if you will look at this query, which join I have used? I have used the left join. So where is the self-join? That means self-join does not exist practically. Syntactically, it does not exist. It is a concept in which we are joining a table to itself. The self-join. Okay, so this is about the joins we have over here. So this is the structure which I have created, the same structure. It is just to give you a reference. So this is the same structure which I have created. So for your reference, I'm showing this structure. Right. And so a quickly idea about the self-join, very important. Self-join is, it is a concept where we join a table to itself. Self-join is used when we need to compare the two columns of the same table. And second point, self-join does not exist syntactically. Just like you can say left join, right join, full join, where we like table one, left join, table two, table one, say full join, table two. But we never join right table one, self-join, table two. We never write it like this. We are, when we are comparing the table to itself, it is known as a self-join.